Hello and welcome to Method Integration User Tutorials. My name is Errol and today we're going to look at importing customers and customer leads. This is part one of a three-part series. The first two parts will talk about preparing your import and the final part will go through the actual import. Now you might be thinking to yourself, prepare? Why do we need to prepare? And although your spreadsheet might be super awesome, we want to ensure that it's formatted properly so that Method won't start spitting out warnings and errors causing much grief and sadness on your part. Here is my spreadsheet file of customers and customer leads. The first row of your file, as you can see, should have the header names for your customers. So under the full name header, you have the full name. Under the first name, you have the first name. This is obvious. Now when you get over to the right, you also see is active and is lead status only. And here it will say whether the person is active, an active customer, and whether the person is a lead. Now we want to import all of these records into the customer table. And the values under each of the header names have to go into the corresponding fields of the customer table. So in the customer table, you will find a field named name and a field called last name and a field called email and so on. So what does that mean? That means these header names have to match the name of the field exactly. For example, this is called phone as the header. What if it's not called phone in the customer table? We should check that. If it doesn't match exactly, you can fix it later, but if you do it now, it makes life a lot easier. Another thing we want to take a look at is if these values are correct. For example, we have under is active and is lead status only, you have true, and under here you have true and false values. Does the table want that? I don't know. I don't have the table in front of me. So what's the best way that we can verify all this stuff? We can export some values from the table itself. And then we can see what's in there, and then we'll be all confident and rest assured. So here I am back in Method, and I've logged in, and I'm going to go to Customize. I'm going to Integration Tools, and now I'm going to go to Import Export. First, we're going to export a table to a file. The table we want is the customer and customer lead. And bam, look at all these fields. There's so many. We don't want all these fields. We only want the ones here because we want to see if these are correct. So I am going to scroll to the bottom and you will find unselect all. Now there is nothing selected. But I'm going to manually go through here and I'm going to go and check off the names. And I won't make you watch me do that. I will fast forward to the future. I'm done. Should I export the file? No, because that will export all my customers. And what if I have many? What if you have 20,000 customers? You don't want to export all of them. You only want to get a handful. And how do we only export a handful of customer records? The cool thing is every customer has a unique number attached to it. And this is called the record ID. I'm going to jump to the customers tab over here. And at the bottom of the grid, I'm going to scroll down, I will see a gear. I'm going to click that gear, and there are hidden fields not being shown to us. So let's check Entity Record ID and click Update. Now you might be thinking, why the Entity Record ID and not the Record ID? And that's beyond the scope of this tutorial. Just trust me that this is what you have to do. And when I scroll up, I will see another column has been added, Entity Record ID. And I will sort that from smallest. You can barely see it, but there's a little arrow that shows that it goes from smallest to largest. And we can see the smallest value we have for the entity record ID is 295. And the largest is 369. So if I want to grab, let's say, the first five entity record IDs, I could always say, just give me back the record IDs that are less than 300, and I'll just get these five. Does that make sense? Cool. Let's go back to Customize. And here we are. It remembered where we last were. And now we'll click Advanced Filter Options. And we'll go to Filter with Script. This is going to be a bit tricky. We're going to put in an expression. We want to return only the record ID, where record ID is less than or equal to 300. For you, it might be, I don't know where your records start. Your records could start at 1,000, or maybe your records are normal and they start at 1, unlike mine. And so just find yourself a value that would make sense here, less than or equal to 10, who knows. And once you've done that, we are going to export to file. And this pops up, and I can open it up in a spreadsheet program. All I have is Google, so I'm going to open up in there. Great, and here's the file that it exported. As you can see, we have in the first row the header names, and the values underneath. They aren't in the same order as my original file, but that doesn't matter, as long as we have the correct names. And I will also check to see if the values are what they want. So all my customers are all customers, so this is false, but it seems that they want a true false value for is active and is lead status only. So this is good. Header names are the correct, values are correct, and we are almost ready to import. Join us in part two of this exciting series. And if you have any questions, by all means, leave them in the YouTube, or you can tweet us at MethodCRM. Have a great day, and I'll see you then. Bye-bye.